today. Can everybody stand on y'all feet, please, please? Can we give God a hand praise and a thank you? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. See, if you'll praise God now, you might get what you want next year. Can you give God a hand praise? He's worthy to be praised. We're going to ask everybody to bow their heads for a quick word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you, God. We just thank you, God, not just for another day, but we just thank you, God, just for another life in Jesus Christ on today, God. Father God, you know all things, God. But you knew, God, over 2,000 years ago, God, that we was going to need an everlasting present, God. And that would be Jesus Christ, Father God. So right now, God, we just say thank you, God. Not just on for today, God, but we say thank you, God, for everything that you've done for us, God. From the smallest to the greatest, God, you're always there, God. And we just thank you, God. Precious Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we just thank you for just giving your life. For the Bible said that you were delivered for our offenses, but you was raised for our justification. And I thank you, Jesus, for you didn't have to do it, because the Bible also says that while we were yet sinners, you willingly went and died for us, Jesus. And I thank you, God. I thank you for your precious Holy Spirit, God, that comforts us, that leads us and directs us and guides us, Father God. For you are so worthy, God. And I thank you, God. So many people, God, are waiting on the next blessing, God. But I thank you for what you've already done, Father God, because you're so worthy, God. Father God, I thank you for even giving me courage to stand up here on today, God. I just lost my dad last week and buried him, God. But I still say thank you, God. Because you're so worthy, God. A lot of times we're hurt, God, because you give the best gifts, God. And I thank you, God. I ask right now, God, that your Holy Spirit just cover this place, God. Let them go home, God, like they had their first experience with you all over again on today, God. Holy Spirit, just fall afresh on this place, God. For you are so worthy, God. I ask that you just bless everybody in the place on today, God. Bless every family represented, God. Bless every friend represented, God. Bless the choir. Bless the singing, the preaching, God. Or whatever may go forth for your glory, God. And I just thank you, God. And we just love you on today, God. We need you, God. We want you, God. We gotta have you in our lives, God. If we didn't get anything on Christmas, God, we got you. So, God, you've been more than fair to your people, God. You've been a God that's been so understanding, God. You've been a God that sticks closer to us than any mother, brother, or kid, God. Father God, we choose you today on today, God. We put you first over everything, God. First over these presents, God. First over the big meal we're about to eat, God. First over our wives and our husbands, God. We choose you first, God. Now, God, we just thank you, God, and we just praise you, God, and we honor you on today. Let the church say amen. 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 God is good. And all the time. Amen.
Hallelujah. Can we stand on our feet this morning? Can we give God the best gift? How many of you know the best gift is our praise and our worship? Can we make room, hallelujah, for Jesus this morning? Hallelujah. Can we make room in our heart that he might receive the greatest gift? Hallelujah. We bless your name, God. We give you praise. We thank you, God. Hallelujah. Come on, if you're ready to give God praise, just shout in this house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Bless your name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come on, let's just put our hands together. Hallelujah. Let's let the Lord know how much we appreciate him. Can somebody make some noise in here? I said, can somebody make some noise in here? Hallelujah. We bless your name, God. Hallelujah. We give you praise. Glory to the highest.
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 Glory. your name, Jesus. Jehovah Shalom. He's my peace. Hallelujah. Somebody don't have peace this morning. But somebody call it Jehovah Shalom. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jehovah Rapha. Hallelujah. He's my healer. Somebody just say he's my healer. Hallelujah. Jehovah Nisi. He's the banner over me. Hallelujah. We bless your name, Jesus.
Lord in this place this morning. Hallelujah. You come on, tell him he's awesome. He is awesome. He is an awesome place. God. He is an awesome God.
Just grab your neighbor by the hand. We're not coming to the altar today, but we're going to at least pray right now.
You are on
God, everyone in this place, bless them right now. We're celebrating your birthday today. I know no one, that is a bigger giver than you, God. So we thank you for the abundance of blessings that you poured out on each and every one of us, every individual and every family. God, we pray now you'll give strength and give comfort, Lord. Even today, we lift up Mother Porter in the hospital. And we thank you for bringing our sister Nikki out of the hospital. We thank you for bringing Dad Hunter out of the hospital. We just thank you, Lord, right now for your healing anointing. Hallelujah. Bringing Sister Delphine out of the hospital. We thank you for your healing anointing. We thank you today as we celebrate you, God. We pray for the whole world today. We pray, God, even for Nigeria, God. Even this, oh God, an attack upon churches. Lord, this day we pray, God, give comfort to those families in Nigeria. Give comfort around the world, God. In Afghanistan, God, and other places where the suicidal bombers and car bombers, God. We pray for suffering people. We pray, God, even in our community, for the Mullins family. We pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus, for the Smith family and other families, God, that we don't know to call their name. But, Lord, even in the midst of it all, we lift up our hands. Come on above our heads. Say it together.
Sue on Saturday the 31st at noon. Am I correct? Okay. And then please come back New Year's Eve for our program. Where did I see it at? It starts at 9 o'clock, right, Pastor Miller? 9 p.m. New Year's Eve. Be here because years ago we used to be there. So we can be here now. All right? All right. Sister Linda, can I get the deacons? Do you need this moved? No. Yes, deacons, come help me move. Help me. I'll be moving. I'm not going to do anything.
Thank you. when I open my eyes, yeah, see the stars in the sky. There's not a day that goes by, no, that I don't wonder why to see, to feel, touch and taste. Don't believe there's a God somewhere up there. Oh yeah, I didn't do that. Tips of my toes, through all the sounds that I hear, oh, the precious smells that teases my nose, through music and dance, through love and romance.
In the house today. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Hallelujah. Y'all be seated. I'm going to try to get y'all out here by noon. Come on, let's thank the Lord for Nikki Haynes is in the house today. She was in the hospital, but look at God. Come on, somebody, look at God. Hallelujah. Come on, Sister Delphina's in the house. Y'all don't even know. Y'all don't even know. Y'all don't even know. You don't even know how good God is. Last Sunday night, the doctors gave up on Delphina. But look at God. Look at God. Look at God. Hallelujah. Somebody better shout for Delphina. Hallelujah. We could be in a funeral. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, my, 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 my. I see Sabriana in the house today. Where's Sabriana today? Come on, thank God for Sabriana. Move down our ladders. But look at God. Hallelujah. Sophia Sue. There's somebody with her today. I think, I don't know if this is her mom. Is it your mom? Is it mom? Yes, come on, let's thank God for Sophia Sue's mother. Hallelujah. Oh, there's a big, 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 big celebration going on. Hallelujah. Oh, we're going to have a time. Hallelujah. Look at old Dwayne. Look at him. He's sitting there. Lord have mercy. Whoa, yeah, 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 yeah. I don't know about y'all, but I feel good. Anybody feel good? Hallelujah. Anybody know this is a celebration? Hallelujah. Come on, give God some glory. Hallelujah. Get back up one more time and give God some glory. Let yourself, let God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo, this is a special, special Sunday because we get to celebrate December the 25th. Hallelujah. Not just any Sunday, but this is the first day of the reason why we come to church every Sunday, and that is to celebrate Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank God for everybody, everybody, everybody here today. Hallelujah. You may be seated. Oh, bless his holy name. Thank God for everyone today. Lovely companion today. Thank God for everybody here today. My little pretty little Victoria, look at her. She got on her boots and her leopard. Diva in progress. In the making. Right there. Right there. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord for Cam back in sound booth. Thank God for everybody here. It's a blessing today to be in the house of the Lord. And Matthew 6 and 33, it's Christmas, but ain't nothing changed. Today I want to talk to you about, and I didn't give the audio, the sound people, who is it that type stuff up? Them folks, Aaron. To put it up on the boards today because we're just hustling through. But my subject today is Jesus, the master gift. Jesus, the master gift. Now, listen, pair of shoes is a gift, but all they can do is cover your feet. Huh? A suit or dress is a gift, but it can just cover your body a little bit. Come on now. They can give you, some of you young people, some iPods and some Xboxes, and I don't know what else they might have gave you, but it's only a game gift, but it's a gift. Jesus is the master gift. Now we got to understand, this morning we are here to celebrate the master gift. Now this gift right here causes you and I to be able to experience everything else in the earth that you might need, because this gift keeps on giving. So out of Jesus flows all other gifts. Everything that you're looking for, it comes out of Jesus. Now that's why after you get the master gift, Satan tries to trick you out of it. Soon as the Lord saves you, the devil tries to get you to not trust Jesus, the master gift. Because he knows anything he would offer to you, if he offered you $1 million, it's no comparison to the master gift. If he gives you a man, if he gives you a woman, if he gives you a job, if he gives you a house, if he gives you a car, if he gives you a business, he's still tricking you from the master gift. Because the master gift gives you the wife, gives you the husband, you the job, gives you the house, gives you the car, gives you everything that you're looking for. Jesus is the master gift. See, it's the gift that the enemy don't want you to really ever have really a real encounter with, because he knows that if you get Jesus, the master gift, it'll satisfy everything. Everything that's missing in your life, everything that you desire comes out of the master gift. So when you get Jesus, this is another part of the subject, you got to believe it or not. See, this is the reason why so many folks, after they get the master gift, they give it back, because they are not patient enough for the master gift to manifest what you asked for. See, we're in time. We're in time. We're in a time where you got to wait for stuff to show up. And so what happens is, while you're waiting, the devil tell you it's not coming, and that Jesus somehow is a liar, or that he don't want you to have it. And so you give it back. Because of time, many of us get discouraged and quit serving the Lord because we want the thing that we want right now. And the devil said, I'll give it to you. The only thing is, I got to have your soul. I got to have your dignity. I'll make you feel good today, but I got to make you a junkie in order for you to feel good. I can give you, you know, some companionship, but in the meantime, you got to have the AIDS virus connected to it. Oh, yeah. I can make you feel good, but it will cause you to have lung cancer 25 years from now. I calm your nerves with nicotine, but down the road, you're going to find yourself with an oxygen tank. That's right. That's right. So come on now. The master gift gets you everything you're looking for. His name is Jesus. So look at Matthew 6 and 33. It says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these other things shall be added unto you. What's wrong is, if we don't seek the master gift first, then you're going to find yourself getting the other stuff first and lose the master gift. Now, some people are not even going to discover the master gift, and they're going to believe that they got the best when they don't have the best. Because the scripture says, if you gain the whole world and lose your soul, what does it profit a man? So there's nothing more powerful than Jesus. Now, I don't want to take away from your belief in Santa Claus and all of that for these little sweeties, but I want you to know Christmas is about Jesus. I really want you to know that Jesus is the one that blessed every child with whatever they got this morning. I want you to know all the good gifts come down from the Father of light, and there is no variable shadow of turning. Everything that you're looking for, it comes from Jesus. And everything that you have has come from Jesus, because he's the master gift. The master gift provides you with everything that you're looking for. Okay, let's look at this real quick. Isaiah, let's go real quick. Isaiah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let's look at 9 and 6. Isaiah 9 and 6. Thank you, Jesus. Isaiah 9th chapter in the 6th verse. Isaiah, Old Testament. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and the peace there shall be no end. Upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom to order it, and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Amen? So here, the master gift was sent to us over 2,000 years ago. His name is Jesus. And I thought about it as I was riding the champagne this morning, and I was listening to another preacher. I thought about that, you know, God designed it so that this gift would come to us in disguise. Yeah. The master gift came like it wasn't valuable, because we value stuff based on the bling bling. We really believe we got something when a lot of times it's just a knockoff. It ain't really the real son when he's really your nightmare. She can package herself like she's really your beautiful queen when she's really your nightmare. So anyway, the Lord designed it so that Jesus was born in a stable. Jesus was born in a stanky place. Anybody been to the farm? Anybody been around livestock? And when they say manger, it's that little place where they feed the slop to the animals. That was his bed. That was his entry. And so Jesus was born in a place where there wasn't any Sealy Postopedes. They said he was born on hay. Well, if anybody ever laid on hay, that ain't soft. It's kind of stickily, like, ouch, wait. Okay. Anyway, the master gift was in disguise of who he really was. And then this is another thing I want to ask you ladies about. Oh, my God, when it's time to push. This was no more than a 15-year-old little girl. And there's no place in scripture that said she had, my God. What's the lady to help someone they don't have? There was no midwife. There's no scripture that says she had a midwife. She had no epidural. Is that the word? Yeah, yeah. She did not have no anesthesiologist. Come on here. Because some of y'all are real tough until it get near them pains. And y'all say, y'all better get me some, you better get me some drugs. I need some drugs because my head is turning around and I'm spitting out green stuff. And I don't know what didn't happen to me, but somebody better help me. And this little young man, no more than about 19 years old, had to be her midwife. Oh, my God. They were in a barn with some livestock, and there was no glass in barns. Come on now. It was cool. It wasn't hot. It was where the hawk was blowing through. The wind was blowing through. Come on here. And they didn't have any shelter really around them, just born, because there was no room for them in the inn. See, do y'all know that's why the devil don't want you to discover this master gift? Because he wants you to think that it's not valuable. He don't want you to really realize who Jesus really is and that he's greater than crack cocaine. He's greater than Jack Daniels. Come on here. He's greater than meth. He's greater than a man. He's greater than a woman. He's the master gift. But the devil don't want you to ever discover it. First thing happened when children begin to have to go to church, the devil makes them rebel. I'm not go to church. Pow! Get your little butt in. You don't even play with them about going to school, but you ask them, do they want to go to church? Why? Because the devil never wants them to discover the master gift. How many of us in here wish we had to discover the master gift? Oh, my God, long before we discovered it. Anybody had any hang-ups? Is there anybody in this room that was bound by some stuff? Is there anybody in this room that made some wrong choices? Is there anybody that got your life in quicksand and you just kept going down and you kept going down? And the more you struggled, the further down you went. And right when you was about to go under, you called the master gift. You said, Jesus, rescue me. I didn't mess up, Jesus. I'm sorry, Jesus. Start to hit the ground and you put your pride aside and you cried out, Jesus, help me, Jesus. Hey, he come running to your rescue. He didn't wait for you to get cleaned up. He didn't wait till you stopped smoking dope. He didn't wait till you got married. He didn't wait till you got your degree. He didn't wait till you got a car. He didn't wait till you got a house out north. But right when you called him. Come on, somebody say, Jesus, the master gift. Yeah, the best gift you could ever receive is not under your tree. It's not going to be in no box. It ain't going to be in no mail. It's already given. Has anybody been rejected? Has anybody in this room ever been talked about? Has anybody in this room put oh my God, been put down and pushed aside and told you ain't good enough and you don't count and you ain't worth nothing? Is there anybody went through a divorce? Is there anybody that had folks that you thought loved you and they turned their backs on you? Is there anybody here that went through molestation, went through some kind of confusion, had a mother walk away, had a father to walk away? Is there anybody been hurt in church and thought that everybody would love you back because you gave your life to Christ, but you found out that when you got to the church, and when you got to that marriage, when you got those children that walked away from you and won't even acknowledge you on Mother's Day, won't even call you on Christmas morning? Have you ever been in a place where you thought your world was going to be turned upside down, and you called Jesus and he came to your rescue? Somebody say he's the master gift. Come on, somebody say he knows just how I feel. Come on, somebody, how many know the master gift? Jesus. How many know Jesus won't kick you to the curb? How many know Jesus? You can backslide 100 times and Jesus will still be there for you. How many know when you say, I'm ready to come back, Daddy? He said, all I was doing was waiting on you to come on back. I don't care how long you've been gone. I don't care where you've been. I don't care how much dope you smoked. I don't care how many men and women you slept with. I don't care if you got your sex life twisted up. I don't care if you've been through 5 divorces. I don't care where you've been. When you say Jesus, come on, we're celebrating the master gift this morning. Somebody said, can't nobody do you like Jesus? Hallelujah. Uh-huh, uh-huh. A man can do so much for you, but Jesus can do anything for you. I read the book, he said anything. Anything you asked in my name, the master gives. I can heal your body. I can save your soul. I can open doors that no man can shut. Come on here. I can give you peace that passes all understanding. At midnight, I can rock you. Come on here. When they tell you they're not going to hire you, the master gives. I give you favor with man. I'll make them give you what they said they wasn't going to give you. Yeah. We up this morning to celebrate the master gift. Uh-huh. It ain't under a tree, y'all. I don't care what they gave you. It is no comparison to what Jesus has for you and what Jesus can do for you. I have to be real careful when I say to people, I go and I check on them and in situations, and I say, if anything I can do, let me know. And I'm just trying to be nice, being a preacher and everything. And some of them say, give me $1 million. See, they know I ain't got it. But they know I'm just trying to be nice, but they're going to try to call me out like, okay, give me $1 million. You said anything. Come on, somebody say, Pastor Miller, it's not your master gift. Your master gift is Jesus. Some people watch me real close so they can find that I am not a perfect man, so they can get their feelings hurt. But I've been telling them all along, I'm not your salvation. I'm not your master gift. I'm only another man that said, Jesus, help me, Jesus. Yeah. It's amazing how many sinners are being delivered by Jesus who don't have mercy on other sinners. Sinners who get mercy don't even get mercy. As soon as I get you, I'm going to get you. But Jesus, have mercy on me. We keep saying, whosoever will, let him come. And the folks get mad because whosoever wills have come in there just like them. The whosoever wills came. And after the whosoever wills get here, then they don't want the whosoever will. Somebody said, you better get the master gift. He ain't like church folks. Church folks will kick you to the curb the minute they hear, they think, they thought, they might. Come on, rest on your feet. I've been doing it about 3 weeks now. I got to finish with this one. This is the one that's been cutting me so deeply with so much love and so much compassion. This one right here. This St. John 3:16 has been getting me for about 3 weeks. I've been touched by this verse. Thank you. Lord, give me more of the God kind of love. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. He gave the master gift. And he said, whosoever believeth in him shall not perish. Is anybody here that can testify if it had not been for Jesus? If I didn't believe in Jesus, I would have perished. I would have been gone already. I would have my family. I would have my job. I would have all these presents today. I would have all the love. And Jesus loved me. Does anybody can testify that Jesus loved you when you were not lovable, when you didn't have nothing coming? The master gift is able to love us. The only one, don't y'all ever forget this, the only one that can love you when you're not lovable is Jesus. When you ain't got nothing coming, God has sent us the master gift. Please stop looking for the God kind of love from humans. Quit getting your hurt feelings all the time because you think a human is supposed to love you like Jesus, and you don't love nobody like Jesus loves them either. Come on, bow your heads. Thank you, Father. Thank you for the master gift. Thank you for the master gift. Thank you for the master gift. Thank you that I believe on today that the master gift is able to save my soul from a burning hell. No matter what I've done, no matter where I've been, no matter who I've hurt, no matter who don't love me today, no matter who comes against me, nobody can stop me from being blessed today because you, God, have sent us the master gift. It's the master gift. Out of Jesus flows my deliverance. Out of Jesus flows my healing. Out of Jesus flows my peace. Out of Jesus flows my resurrection. Out of Jesus, he contains my sanity when I would lose my mind. Thank you, Master Gift. Nobody knows what I'm going through, but Jesus, been misunderstood. Been talked about. Microscope around me. Everybody trying to see what I can find on him. Find on him. But the master gift, he said, I don't wait to find anything on you, cause I already know what you done done, and I know what you're getting ready to do. But I love you. I love you anyhow. I'll never leave you. If you go to jail, I'll be with you. If you go to the hospital, I'll be with you. If you walk around on the streets with a drug addiction, I'll be with you. If you're bound by alcohol, all I'm waiting for is for you to say, help me, Jesus. I'm tired, Jesus. I messed up, Jesus. You don't have to be the best father. You don't have to be the best mother for Jesus to love you. You don't have to be the best husband. You don't have to be the best wife. You don't have to have no money in your pocket right now. You don't have to sing best. You don't have to preach best. You don't have to have a degree. You don't have to be a certain skin color. You don't have to be a man if you are, oh my God, a woman. You don't have to be a woman if you are a man. He love you. He love you. He love you. The master gift. Let it flow into you right now. Let it flow into you right now. Let it flow into you right now. Let it flow. He wants to flow into you right now. People come burdened. People come depressed this morning. People come with hurt feelings. Possibly you didn't get what you wanted under the tree, but I hear the master gift say, let me comfort you today. Somebody lost a loved one and you got a void, and the Lord said, let me fill that void. I'm the master gift. I'll be your father. I'll be your mother. Somebody's child didn't make it home. He said, I'll be your child. Somebody's family going through a storm. Somebody's in trouble. Grab your neighbor's hand. Now become an intercessor right now. Say, God, if my neighbor needs you this morning, let him call on you, Jesus. Let him not be too proud in this room. Let him know nobody can judge you here. They're all sinners, saved by grace. We are all sinners, saved by grace. Nobody's perfect. Nobody's done what they should have done. But he loves us anyhow. Lord, touch my neighbor. Lord, touch my neighbor. Use me, Lord. Let them feel the love of you flow through me, God. The master gift offers himself to you right now. The master gift offers himself through you right now. Come on. You're in this room. Come on. Come on, say it. Don't wait for next Christmas. Don't wait for tomorrow. Come on, say it right now. Jesus, the master gift, I receive you. In Jesus' name, amen. Merry Christmas. God bless you. Merry Christmas.